Writing was my passion from my early days. Some incidents during my engineering life and college life, love breakups, then frustrations. So all these things led me to start writing my own diary. And through that diary came my first book, Floating Self Concept. So it's been like 6 years I'm into writing now. 2011, my first book released, Floating Self Concept. And in 2018, now it's 10th book, She Friend Zone My Love, which is released. So quite an exciting journey. And but then yes, it started with a diary and a thought, which was inspired by a friend. He told me that I should go ahead and publish that particular diary. So a little bit of manipulation into those things, and then after making it in the form of a novel, I submitted it to two publishers. One of the publishers accepted it. So that happened in 2008 and 9. So it took like a couple of years to get published, to get reply from the publisher, and in 2011 the first book was released.
Right, thank you, sir. And then, like, there is a story behind every story. What inspired you to write this particular novel, that is, She Friendzone My Love?
I think the whole topic of whole issue of body shaving and the friend zoning, both the things, I wanted to include it in the same book. And because it is quite important to understand the psyche of the other person when the other person has friend zoned you, or even if it is about the body shaming. I've been telling this to everyone through an interview or be it a book launch or anything, that it is not mandatory to be in a good shape, but then yes, you need to be fit, but then you need to eat a zero figure, to eat a six pack abs always. And for those who are not professional, it's not a mandatory thing also. For those who are into an IT field, what is a six pack abs going to help you? Nothing. It's basically a pain that is going to help you. Then we live in an Instagram world, we are around the perfect bodies, the perfect beauties around us, it's personalized, be it magazines or the movies or everything. And that somewhere depresses and gets into the bullying zone, which I wanted to avoid.
Sir, when I was going through your bio, I also found that you write scripts for TV shows. So, how is it different from writing a novel, and is it fun?
Quite different. Writing scripts is very different than writing a novel. In a novel, if I have to just sum it up, in a novel, there are even 15-20 odd bad pages which reader doesn't write. He'll still go ahead and read the entire book. But then that happens with television, and a viewer has a choice to switch the channel. So that gets very difficult. Your TRP goes down, so you have to bang on each and every time. And even the writing is very difficult. You don't have the liberty yourself. You are dependent upon the other writers, the producers, the directors, and the budget and everything. But then in the book, you can show anything you want. You have that kind of liberty in front of you, where I can show probably the costliest thing in the world, and I'm visiting the costliest place in the world. But then that cannot happen with a television. So there are foundations, but then it's quite fun, quite crisp, and you have to be on your toes each and every time. There are no nights and days in that particular job. Even if you get a call at 1 at the night that you need to rewrite the entire story, rewrite the entire episode, you need to be up for it.
Alright. So we have this interesting round, that is Sudeep Shoot Round, which is basically a rapid fire. I'll be telling some words and you need to answer. So first is inspiration.
I think my readers.
Strength.
My wife.
Role model.
Role model, there will be two, Sachin Tendulkar and Shah Rukh Khan.
Favorite pastime?
Pastime, reading books, nothing better than that.
Favorite writer?
There are many and it's very difficult to name one, but then I'm currently fond of Jhampa Lahiri's books.
Food?
Food, anything that I get on the way. Just like I'm a foodie, so whatever comes to me when I'm hungry, I can eat anything. But then yes, when it's about the launches and everything, I do keep a control over the food, because when you start a book launch, means like the first book launch, you're probably 68, 70, and then it's the last book launch, you're 75 and 80. So you need to have that kind of control, because it's always outside food.
Movie.
Quite difficult again to name one. But then I like Avarapan a lot. There's no reason as such, but then I love Avarapan.
Alright, that was fun. So there's a question. If you had the abilities to and chance to change one thing about this world, what would it be?
Make people smile. I think that is the biggest thing, and the most important thing which people have forgotten these days. Just running behind money and then the materialistic things, it is important to smile.
Yeah, that is indeed the best thing. Now, there are many aspiring writers, but somehow they back out either due to lack of confidence or family support. So what is your message to them?
Be patient in all the entire writing process, and you need to have faith in yourself. It's quite obvious, there's nothing wrong that will face a backlash from your parents, from your friends, because you're choosing a field which is quite different, quite odd, and people look up to these fields as a hobby or anything like that, even for a photographer or a dancer or a sports field for that case. But then you need to have that faith in yourself and you need to just go on and prove the world wrong.
So lastly, Preksha, being a starter, what is your message or suggestion for us?
Keep growing, keep smiling, and keep doing the good work. I hope that you achieve all the success and all the best.
Thank you so much, Sudeep ji. It was ended up, like, thank you for your precious words and your valuable time. Thank you so much.